Hi, so this video is about the Visconti Homo sapiens. I got it as the Steel Age version, and the first one I purchased was the Bronze Age version. And it's about the material and the cap closing mechanism. If you see, you can see this one, if I push it down, the cap goes up from the spring inside, and it easily opens and closes. The second one I got, I purchased new, but not from a Visconti retailer, and it was very hard to open, so I had to really get it in my hands and then push it down and turn it, twist it, to open and to close. And this was not that annoying at first, because I had the easily opening one and I carried it around with me, and I noticed that it might happen that you press the cap and the pen opens while carrying it, and so you can easily damage your nib, it is exposed, it can dry up. So it wasn't that bad that this one was stronger. But after a while I noticed that this the Visconti logo on the clip actually rubs off. So the white metal is just from the clip, and they add this black color to it, and it's not that hard to remove it. The first cap I got, you could actually just rub over it with your thumb, and it was rubbed away. The second one I then got is better, but you can see it already starts to rub off. And I think this is part of the hard closing cap and hard opening cap, because you take it in between your hands and you twist it, and if it doesn't open, you get your thumb against the color, and then it rubs off because you have to use so much pressure. So I wrote to Visconti about this, and they told me that it's due to the difference in material, and they can't machine it that precisely, and they have tolerances, and that's the reason you may get a pen that opens easily, or you may get a pen that is really hard to open and to close. So they suggested to, I think, add some oil or like grease to the threads, and they would just grease this up, and then you hope that it will close better. That's actually not such a good idea in my opinion, because the material is hygroscopic and you might close the pores and it might get different to the touch, but I don't know how it will actually affect your feeling of the resin in material, of the volcano stone resin material. So I found a better way. Well, at least for me it was better, but it was a bit daring, you might say. First of all, I tried to remove part of the cap. Let me see if I can show you this. In this cap there are small bumps that grip into the threads in the pen. There you can see it slightly. And first I thought the cap was the problem, so I tried to remove or make them smaller, these bumps, so they would better grip into the pen. But as I said, I've got this one also, and it has the same cap, and if I exchanged it, the cap from the steel one also closed easily on the Bronze Age one. So this wasn't a problem. Then next, I tried to enlarge the grooves here, which actually did not help at all either, because it would was a similar problem, that the cap is okay and the threads in the cap are okay, these stubby little things. But I thought maybe the pen itself was thicker, so the cap would grab in these grooves more. But this wasn't also the problem. Don't want this to dry up. What helped in the end is actually the pen is bigger than the caps. I don't know why, but these caps were fairly similar for me. They are always the same diameter, maybe because they can just drill into it. I don't know how exactly this is made, but these threads within the Homo sapiens were a bit too large for the Steel Age version. So what I did is I took some Tesafilm. And you put it around the metal, not to scratch it. And try to keep the upper edge from the film exactly at the metal or slightly above. So this should protect the metal at least a bit. And then you could just take a nail file, and this one goes up to the edge, so it's the whole side can be used to file. And one is slightly more abrasive and one is less abrasive. This one is more abrasive. And then you would just take it, maybe put your thumbnail down to the metal, and you start running over the pen like this. And you use just a bit of pressure, not too much, and you go like this. You can go a bit faster and just go around the threads to make it even and smooth. And just do this like once around, then test it again if it closes better or if it's still hard to close, and then you put it out again, file around the threads. This worked for me. So I did this for like an hour, and after that time I got it to be so much reduced that it closes easily. It still has the problem if you press down on the cap hard, it will stick, and you can kind of release it a bit and then it goes up, but if you just press slightly it will be pressed up from the spring again. So that's just for you to see if you actually open it or close it, it is really smooth. So you can't feel anything and it closes securely, but you don't need so much force as before. Yeah, maybe this helps you if you have a Visconti and you don't want to send it to Italy, or maybe don't want to send it again to Italy. You can just try this on your own. And as you can see, there are not too many differences in the material, so you can't see that I filed it. You can see it a bit, especially on the borders. There are like small bumps in it, but maybe you can remove them. I did not care enough to actually remove it up to now. Maybe it will get worn off from your fingers when you use it a lot. But as you see, in comparison to the other Visconti, just from looking at it, you would not necessarily notice a difference. Of course, this one was in the ink. This one was inked already, and the threads are colored from the ink. That one is fairly new. There you can see a bit abrasive. I also tried to remove to deepen these grooves, but it was not such a good idea, so don't do that. Yeah, maybe this helps you. You can try it out so you know what the problem would be if you have a hard closing with Conti. You can try this. I don't know if you really want to, but it helped me. So, with this, bye.